Good luck.
Thank you again. Do you ever get nervous before making a speech? My friend Mick gets really nervous. Colm, he asked me recently, how do I control my nerves? Just imagine the audience sitting in their underwear. Then you'll realize they're only ordinary mortals. But I don't have a good imagination. In that case, take my special spectacles. Wear these and you'll see the audience in their undies. I wonder, do they still work? Oh, what a selection of undies. Calvin Klein. Ann Summers. Dunn's Stores. Madam Contest Chair, ladies and gentlemen, isn't it great to laugh, to have a bit of fun? Don't you feel good? Good fooling is good fun. It takes our minds off the seriousness of life. Life today is full of stress. Stress can kill. Laughter makes the seriousness of life bearable. As Mark Twain once said, the human race has only one really effective weapon, and that's laughter. However, we don't just choose to laugh or not to laugh. We choose our very lives. We own our lives. We are masters of our own destiny. Don Miguel Ruiz once said, maybe we cannot escape the destiny of the human, but we do have a choice to suffer our destiny or to enjoy our destiny. Fellow Toastmasters, it's your choice. Endure or enjoy. According to research, people who laugh a lot and enjoy life live longer and have a 55% lower risk of death. The American comedians Bob Hope and George Burns both lived to be 100. When George was asked the secret of his longevity, he said, with a glint in his eye, I smoke 8 to 10 cigars a day. I drink 5 martinis a day and surround myself with beautiful women. And what does my doctor say? Nothing. My doctor's dead. On the other hand, take my workaholic friend, Noel. His life was dull, dreary, drab. No fun. He developed cancer. However, he was one of the lucky ones. He survived. Colm, he told me afterwards, when I knew I was going to survive, it made me wonder, survive for what? More work, more business, more productivity. I began to realize what a gray, empty life I had. Colm, I decided to change, to enjoy life again, to find fun, to go to the park and the theater, to travel, to see the world, to follow my dreams. Too long. I had endured life. It was now time to enjoy life. Let's not make the same mistake Noel made. Let's not wait to get sick. Life goes quickly. Can you all do something for me? Put your hand on your heart. Everyone, put your hand on your heart. Feel it beat. Can you feel it? It's ticking its way towards your end. Few people realize the value of their time until they come to the end. For many, the dreams of youth become the regrets of later life. Why? What's the number one regret many people have when they look back on their lives? I wish I hadn't taken life so seriously. When was the last time you let yourself go? Laughed yourself silly? When was the last time you really enjoyed life? My speech co-writer, Mark Twain, once said, 20 years from now, you'll be more disappointed by the things you didn't do than by the things you did do. Fellow Toastmasters, those 20 years can slip by very quickly. We'll never again have a life like this one. Don't let it slip by. Cherish it. Savor it. And don't forget, have fun. But first, buy some new underwear. Contest there.